Captain Burnham, Ferengis, a cataclysmic anomaly, and Nevar, finally rejoining the Federation. What else might we expect of Season 4 of Star Trek Discovery, and what might it bring? Welcome to Trek Central, I'm your host Captain Jack, and let's get right into it. A new trailer for Star Trek Discovery Season 4 has dropped at New York Comic Con 2021 at the Discovery panel, which featured most of the cast of the show. Let's break it down and chat more about the upcoming 4th season, plus all the details on how and where you can watch it. If you want to keep up to date on all the latest Star Trek news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from myself and the team here at Trek Central. Because if you're talking about Star Trek, then we want to hear about it. You can also follow us on social media for daily updates on the Star Trek universe. Okay, let's hit it. As mentioned, we're breaking down the trailer. Now, due to copyright and ViacomCBS being too hasty of YouTube content ID, we're unable to show you the trailer in full in this video. So head down below to view it and then come back here for all the details. The opening shot is newly promoted Captain Michale Burnham in some 32nd century tactical gear, a clear advancement from the old 23rd century gear, but not massively from a first glance. Discovery looks to be burning up in atmosphere, but it might actually be entering this gravimetric anomaly, which we see from another shot. And the gravimetric anomaly does look extremely imposing, and you really do get a sense of the scale. In previous teasers and trailers, we've been told this threat is light years in size, but I think only when this trailer zooms away from a Discovery to this anomaly does everything start to make sense and while it's so threatening. Captain Burnham's being rocked around in some kind of area, with a single chair and a circle around her. This could be a new shuttlecraft, as we do see a couple of shuttles in some kind of hangar bay. Considering the hangar bay was considerably damaged from Bookship ramming into it at the end of Season 3, it would make sense. These shuttles definitely look like 32nd century variants of the Discovery era worker bees, which is cool. Now finally, we have a return of Dadmiral, Admiral Vance played by Oded Fehr. Vance was a great character in Season 3, so I'm glad we are getting more of him and look forward to whatever he does in Season 4. Given Vance's popularity in Season 3, I'm hoping we really get to see more of his storyline expanded as the show goes on. But Vance isn't the only leading Federation character we get this season. We finally get confirmed the identity of a Federation president, President Rylak, played by Chila Hosdal. Chila was notable in Amazon Prime's The Man of the High Castle TV show. It appears that her character is part Cardassian, Bajoran, and human, which is absolutely amazing. Basically a character which comes about due to the events of Star Trek Deep Space Nine. And not just the Federation president, but other representatives of the Federation. From another loss of representation, Orion and Nevar's President Tarina, we also see the trailer accepting the flag of the Federation from Federation President Rylak, presumably being accepted back into the United Federation of Planets. It might be that we also see a Trill character in this scene, in a yellow robe, as you can just about make out the Trill logo on the holographic displays. Talking about these holographic displays, when the scene is flipped, you can see what they say, with the displays having the menus of voting, settings, systems, and library, as well as a power-off setting. So it seems like this scene will have some Federation politics, and maybe councillors assemble to vote on something about this gravimetric anomaly. What we also see in the scene is new Starfleet dress uniforms, which is a richer red wraparound uniform with a white collar. Whether other divisions are a similar colour or are richer versions of their own colours, a richer yellow and blue, is unknown. But the uniform does look really nice, and I do like to see more dress uniforms in Star Trek. One of the biggest talks about this trailer is we see a Ferengi Starfleet officer with a new design. Whether this is a complete redesign of a Ferengi, or just a simple part Ferengi is unknown. Discovery Season 3 had numerous updates on legacy Trek species from Lurians, Cordonites, and Cardassians, but not complete redesigns. So I'm more inclined to say that this is not a redesign, but instead just a partial update. It's interesting to note, however, that a Ferengi does bear an interesting resemblance to some original Ferengi concept art from Andrew Probart. And I think it's always cool when TV shows use the wealth of concept art in new ways. Similar to how the USS Discovery being a reuse of old concept art done by Ralph McQuarrie. A part Ferengi in Starfleet would be a great way to work in any continuity about the legacy of Rom as a Negus of the Ferengi Alliance, with the legacy of Captain Nog being the first Ferengi Starfleet officer being cemented by ships being named after him. If there is a part Ferengi, and it would mean that Rom's Ferengi Alliance continued to move to a more progressive and inclusive society. This Ferengi might even be captain of the USS Nog, which would be pretty cool. There is a scene of Starfleet officers around a holographic projector looking at the anomaly smashing a moon into a planet. This could be Earth, and would be a good way to get Earth back into the Federation if they save him from his calamity. President Rylak talks to Burnham about what leadership truly means, which makes sense considering that she is the leader of the United Federation of Planets. I would know a thing or two about leadership. Already I'm getting a strong appreciation for his character, though part of me thinks there might be some alternative motives from the president, Or that's just me being paranoid, who knows at this point. But we hear this as we see Burnham and Book on a away mission in the forest getting shot at. A similar scene was seen in season 3, with Burnham and Book on Quijon getting shot at. This forest is more luminescent than Quijon's, and Burnham is rocking a leather away mission jacket, which reminds me of the excursion jacket used by Vulcans in the Enterprise episode Carbon Creek. Federation HQ looks slightly different this season, in some scenes on still being in a cloaking field seen in season 3, but in others out in space, so presumably opens itself up, symbolising its turn to form. The space station is also slightly different in structure, with more root-like structures around it and floating platforms around the space station, some being connected by cables. What purpose they serve is so far unknown. Captain Burnham, Lieutenant Tilly, and some co-op Malot nuns, including Burnham's mother, go to visit some ruins, with Tilly and Burnham wearing their tactical vests. Presumably this is on the hunt for clues about the mysterious anomaly, which perhaps could have an ancient origin. Hopefully not like season 3 once again, as that was rather naff. While in the ruins, the group discovers some sort of alien corpse and are attacked by an unknown assailant. Lieutenant Tilly is seen over the corpse of a Starfleet officer, wearing the older grey 32nd century uniforms, which could imply this is damage occurred at the Federation HQ, as officers there are seen wearing the older uniform, and could link into what we just mentioned. In the hangar bay-like area previously described, we see the Discovery uniform again on Burnham, actually giving a speech on some officers in different uniforms as well. These could be cadets that Burnham is overseeing, which would be interesting if Starfleet's opening up again. They would need more cadets and therefore officers to rebuild the Federation and therefore Starfleet. "We're going where no one has gone before," Captain Burnham says, which I really like. This is true to the ethos of Star Trek so much, so I'm very much looking forward to this new frontier, which could be this anomaly. It could be really interesting if the ruins seen previously are within the anomaly, or it could be a nexus situation where there is another imagined world within. Who knows at the end of the day? Captain Saru went off to look after Sakaar at the end of season 3, but from this trailer we see him back in uniform and in Starfleet, though we do see a glimpse of him on what appears to be Kaminar in a very ornate room, showing a holo projector of the galaxy to some other Kelpians. While in his Starfleet uniform, Saru does have a brooch on his uniform, which looks like Fret Gangler surrounded by black obelisks, which could be the symbol of the Kelpian Baal Alliance, which would be a nice symbol of their union. He is also present at the Federation Starfleet Command meeting, alongside Captain Burnham, Admiral Vance, and President Rylak. Book and Burnham were in what looks to be one of the mercantile exchanges seen in Discovery Season 3, with lots of explosions happening around them. And there are other scenes of Book on Quijon with what appears to be his nephew running around. A later scene of Burnham consolidating a shocked Book, so let's hope nothing bad happens to his nephew on Quijon. Star Trek does have a precedent of killing off nephews. Anyway, Lieutenant Tilly and Adira are planetside in some fancy excursion tactical gear, different from the ones we've seen Burnham and Tilly wearing in other scenes in this trailer, and they were accompanied by 3 red shirts. It seems like Star Trek is bringing back random unnamed red shirts back into Trek, which is great, but I feel bad for these guys. There was a late shot of this group firing a phase on something left off screen. Let's be honest, with the red shirts, they're probably going to get killed. And in the next scene, we see another as of yet unnamed red shirt attacked by a sword-wielding person inside the Discovery. But then we cut to Burnham fighting some other unmasked attackers on Book's ship. We also see a Quark Malat nun fighting an attacker on Book's ship, so it seems likely this is happening at the same time. As we saw last season, Stamets isn't the only one who can pilot the spore drive, as Booker can as well due to his natural empathic abilities, as Quijon. It was said during the NYCC panel that we'll be getting more scenes of Book and the Discovery crew, so interaction between him and Stamets on piloting the spore drive could be very interesting. It's going to be fascinating, some would say. But in this trailer, we do see Book in pain while in the spore drive's reaction cube, so what could be causing this is everyone's guess. There is the scene of a random unknown man shouting Saru while in the spore drive area of the ship, which is very weird to say at the least. Additionally, in this montage of scenes, we can also see Jet Reno, who is in a typical place of engineering of the spore drive room, so I'd say it's fantastic to say that she's back in the series once more. A red shirt is attacked by what looks to be a Kolat Mat nun in a weird area, which looks like Discovery's interior, but is green and has the insignia of a USSC-CH visible. This could be a ship with a new registry of USSC, perhaps a United Spaceship Carrier, or it could just be an abbreviation for a different area of ship or a starbase. The hangar of the USS Discovery is completely wrecked, with numerous doctors looking for survivors, as well as Tilly and Adira. This could be a result of gravimetric anomalies, with a lot of the damage being in the hangar bay. Perhaps the ship was trying to dock when Discovery was struck by the anomaly. So much damage happened here than other parts of the ship. Bit interesting. Someone is seen flying towards a new ship or space station in an asteroid field. This might be Captain Burnham, to add some parallels to the very first episode of season 1, where Burnham flies through an asteroid field, and the very first episode of season 2, where Burnham flies through another asteroid field, and the very first of season 3, where Burnham flies through a debris field. She gets to plan quite a bit. So maybe this is the very first episode of season 4 to keep up with a tradition. A weird tradition, might I add, now he pointed it out. Joan Owo, for the sake of not pronouncing her name right, is seen fighting in some sort of ring and punches a guy in the crotch. Yeah, she has some fighting spirit. Now moving sharply away from that, Burnham is seen in some sort of EVA suit captaining the USS Discovery while everything explodes around her, possibly into an anomaly in typical Star Trek style. Tilly, Burnham, and the Quartermonk nuns are on board Book's ship seem to head to a moon, and it could be lunar. But I don't think it is due to be lunar, being as it's very populated, so this could be another planet with a moon, perhaps with the ruins we previously saw this group at. Some planetary shots from season 3 were actually made of real life planetary shots, so this moon could actually be constructed from shots of our moon or somewhere else entirely. There is a beautiful shot of Saru and Burnham planet side, with the sun bearing down on them and structures on the background. I wouldn't be surprised if this shot was constructed in the new AR wall technology that is able to construct these dynamic scenes, such as projecting landscape on scenes around the filming stage. The lighting of the scene makes me think this is the case, with the landscape being rendered in real time, allowing for very good realistic lighting on the actors. We've done some videos, articles, and tweets on the AR wall that Star Trek Discovery is currently using, go check it out. With what looks to be an arid climate of the planet, we could be seeing Navarre, which previous trailers have suggested. Captain Burnham may have moved on from sharing a room with Lieutenant Tilly, but we do get a scene of the two in Tilly's quarters. Her desk has a Starfleet Medal of Honor given to her at the end of season 1 of Discovery, as well as a photograph of herself and Captain Burnham. And that was a breakdown of the season 4 trailer of Star Trek Discovery. We're definitely in for a wild ride of Captain Burnham of the US Discovery, as this rebuilding Federation is facing its gravimetric anomaly, which appears to be tearing up space all around it. Perhaps it's some sort of offshoot from The Burn, which was a disaster explored in season 3 of the series. So who knows, it could be an interesting theory. Season 4 of Discovery will be releasing on Paramount Plus on November 18th in the US and on CTV Sci-Fi in Canada as well as Crave, and presumably will be on Netflix internationally the next day, November 19th. Fun little fact, Discovery will air alongside Star Trek Prodigy, which will also be airing from October 28th onwards. Plenty of Trek content for us all to enjoy and plenty for us to talk about here on the channel. Let us know what you think of the Discovery Season 4 trailer down below in the comment section. And are you even excited for the upcoming release of the 4th season? Either way, comment down below, because if you're talking about Star Trek, then of course, we want to hear about it. Don't forget, you can keep up to date on all the latest Star Trek news, lore, and more by hitting that subscribe button to never miss a video from myself and the team here at Trek Central. You can also follow us on social media or join our community Discord server to discuss Star Trek with your friends. For now, I've been Captain Jack, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Live long and prosper, my friends. Goodbye.